Let's start the next part of the morning session. We have two talks, and the first will be from Yong Zhang from the group that is obviously dominating today, from the Xiamen University.
Yeah. Okay. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Yong Zhang. It's also from Xiamen University. I would like to thank organizer give me the wonderful opportunity to introduce you our recent work. I want to say I'm not good in English too. in fact, this is my first formal talk in English. So I'm nervous. Okay. So I welcome any questions or comments about my talk. But it is very possible that I understand what you say. So I asked my colleague translate for me. I'm very sorry for that, about that. So my title of the title of my talk is Phonons in One-Dimensional Unharmonic Chains. The outline is here. First, I will introduce some basic concept about phonons and about theoretical predictions about phonons dynamics in one-dimensional lattice. And then I will show you some simulation result about a phonon lifetime in one-dimensional chains. And last, I will make a brief conclusion. So, phonon is a very basic concept. It is used to describe thermodynamics and transport properties in solid. So in quantum physics, the phonon is an energy quantum of latest vibrations. They obey the Bose-Einstein statistics. In the class physics, the phonon is a normal mode. There is a theory of a sine type wave and vibrate optically. In harmonic chains, there is no interaction among the phonons, and the amplitude of the phonons is not decay. So in the lattice, the phonon is an energy carrier, so the thermal conductivity in the lattice will be infinite. So the question is, when in the real world, the unharmonic potential is a common, like this, the Linajong potential. If we do the Taylor series expansion for the LJ potential and reserve the first three terms, we can got the famous FP alpha beta model. So the problem is, what happened for the phonons when we consider the unharmonic terms? In a weak unharmonicity, there is a Phonon-Boltzmann equations to deal with phonons. In this theory, the phonons are imagined as gas particles, and the interaction among the phonons are imagined as a collision among them. So the phonon, the amplitude of the phonon will decay, and his frequency will be changed. In this theory, the key quantity to describe the effect of the unharmonicity is the frequency shift. This defines the ratio between the real frequency and the harmonic frequency. And another quantity is line width. Also, we call the inverse lifetime. So, if the unharmonic is become stronger, what happened for the phonons? There is no general theory for this case, but there is some very interesting topic for this here. The first is the so-called minimum heat conduction problem. That means when the system approaches to the stronger unharmonicity limit, how much the heat conductivity is. Very long years ago, the Kitar gave an estimation. They say in the stronger unharmonicity limit, the mean free path of the phonons may be equal to lattice constants. Of course, this is the same physical meanness. Another picture is when in the stronger unharmonicity limit, the phonon may conduct a random walk. That means the stronger unharmonicity stop propagating of the phonon and lead to a random walk. In real material, this case is very hard happen for the crystal because melting will happen when the material gets this stronger unharmonicity limit. So this is a very often happened in the disorder systems. The side of this random walk is the lifetime of the phonon is small than his periodic. Very interesting, our result will show this may be happen in a symmetry one-dimensional chains. Another example, maybe the stronger unharmonics cause the phonon change to another excitants such as the solitons and the breathers. But this topic is very interesting, but it's out of scope of my talk today. So here we talk about the model we used more detail. We used the one-dimensional FPU alpha model. Here the PI is the momentum of the particle, and the XI is the displacement from his equilibrium position. The potential is the FPU alpha model. Here we want to suggest the symmetry of the interaction potential. So what mean is the asymmetry? The asymmetry potential, it means the force pull the neighboring particle is different to the force press them. So when the alpha is equal to zero, this is a FPU beta model, and this is a symmetry. And when the alpha is not equal to zero, this is a FPU alpha model, and this is a asymmetry. And when the alpha increased, the degree of the asymmetry is degraded. When the alpha is increased, the degree of the asymmetry is also increased. So this model is have a two limit. One is the high temperature limit. In this limit, just the cortical term reserved. We call it PFPU model. And another limit is a low temperature limit. This is a change to the harmonic change. So why we suggest the symmetry of the interaction potential? Now, well, we show some example that show the symmetry of the potential is relevant. The first example is the thermal expansion or contraction. This is well known. If the potential is a symmetry, there is no thermal expansion or contraction. When the potential is asymmetry, when the temperature change, the potential will change the equilibrium position of the particle. So this lead to thermal expansions. The Kittel, in his famous textbook, calculated the alpha beta model. Calculate the linear expansion coefficient for the alpha beta model. This is the linear expansion coefficients. If the potential change to the form we used, then the linear expansion coefficient is exactly equal to alpha, minus alpha. That means the potential all used will lead to a thermal contract. It's a different this form, but we checked our result later introduce you. It's not dependent. Not dependent on whether the alpha is minus or plus. So another example shows the symmetry of the potential is relevant is energy equipartition problem. This is an old problem. A paper published in the journal Statistical Physics that show there is a short time to energy equipartition in the asymmetry potential. This picture, the y-axis is the equipartition time, and the x-axis is the coefficient alpha. In his model, the beta is fixed to 2. So this is clearly see when the alpha greater than 2, the equipartition time dramatically discrete. Yeah, because the equipartition problem there is in the initial excited some few phonons, then observe the energy how it spread all the phonons. So the last example is the heat conductivity, normal in one-dimensional conserved lattice with asymmetry potential. This is also a controversial problem in recently. This topic is introduced by Professor Zhao Hong in his talk. I will talk in detail, in some detail. A normalized heat conduction means the heat flux correlation function decay in a power law minus and the exponent lambda smaller than one. That also called the long time tail. This is the side of the normalized heat conduction. But we found in the low temperature and low a small alpha, the correlation function decay in a nearly exponential way, and when the temperature is increased, the long time tail appeared. The higher the temperature, the earlier the long time tail appear. This decay minus is very different from the LPO beta model. That means the symmetry case. But after that, some author report the numerical result show that in the LPO alpha model, indeed the long time tail exist. But we know the parameter here used is different. In our studied, the Obervio fast decay occur at the time at a temperature 0.05, and the alpha is equal to 1, and in this case show the long time tail. The alpha is equal to 2, and the temperature is 0.1. So the fast decay of the flux correlation function is more easily observed at the small alpha and the low temperature. Our result later show you will exponentiate it. So next I begin to introduce you our simulation result about the phonons in one-dimensional anharmonic chains. This is our simulation steps. We use the periodic boundary conditions, and we conduct equilibrium MD simulations at a constant energy. So here, here the system size is take to is set to 2048. So according to the solid theory, the motion of any particle of a chain at the equilibrium is superposition of the normal modes. So we can get the phonon information by calculating the velocity power spectra of a particle. So this is this is the method we used. Very simple, but the velocity time series used to calculate the power spectra would be very long to get the higher solution, a higher frequency solution. So this is our result. This picture is show you the power spectra of a particle velocity as a function of frequency. This is clearly see the blue light indicate the FPU beta model. The red light indicate the FPU alpha beta model. And the dot gray line show the Bell harmonic frequency, harmonic phonon. So this is clearly say a few phonon peaks with the lowest frequencies is very clearly separated from the noise. So we can fit this peak by the Lorentz function, and we can get the measure the frequency and the light waves of the phonon one by one. So today our talk focus on the lifetime. If you interested on the frequency shift, can refer to our paper in the account. So first I want to introduce some theory about the phonon lifetime and the heat conduction and heat conductivity. That means how to calculate the heat conductivity from the phonon lifetime. So the phonon energy is defined by this formula, and the phonon heat current is defined by the phonon energy times phonon group velocity. So we can calculate the heat flux calculation function in this way. Here will appear two terms. The first term is the autocorrelation of the phonon energy, and the second term is the cross correlation between three serial give the gamma. I'm not talk in detail, but for the FPU alpha beta model, the gamma is equal to 3/2, and all these series give the same result for the FPU alpha beta model, but the slightly different predict value is appear for the is appear to for the FPU alpha FPU beta model. The Phonon series predict the 5 over 3, but the mode coupling and hydrodynamics predict to 2. So this is a theory prediction about the gamma. In summary, all theory have two underlying hypotheses. The first is long wavelength approximations. That means the wave number is approaching to zero. And another is the propagating phonons dominate the heat conduction process. That means this required the phonon lifetime is much greater than his period. So we here we show our results. First, I want to determine the two limit for the FPU alpha beta model. For the harmonic limit, in principle, the harmonic the phonon peak in harmonic is not broadened, but in the simulation, we used the finite size, and there are some computer errors, so we can observe the little broaden for the phonon in harmonic chains, but the light width is independent of the k. So the gamma is equal to zero for the harmonic limit. On the other hand, in the PFPU limit, we show the light waves rescale by frequency. So this data is calculated from different coefficient beta and different energy density. All data is collected into one curve in the double log scale. So we can get the slot is this value. Note that this left this light wave is rescaled by the omega, so the gamma is the slot minus one. So the gamma for the PFPU is 1.73. This is the two limits. This is the gamma for the two limits. So in the picture, in the time is not permission, I show the main result. This is the measured value for the gamma in our simulations. This picture shows the gamma, as a function of the energy density. That means the temperature. I will replace say energy density of by the temperature. This is convenient. So this curve is indicated the FPU beta model. That is mean the symmetry model. When the temperature is increased, the FPU beta model really from the harmonic limit cross over to the PFPU limit. But the difference is for the FPU alpha beta model with the alpha is equal to 1.5 and 2. This is not from harmonic limit. This is a begin with Rama nearly equal to 1 and close over to PFPU limit. So in higher temperature, the three model, the three parameter is show no different. Big difference is appear to the low temperature for the asymmetric case and the symmetric case. This is the alpha. What happened in the low temperature region? In the low temperature region, the effect of the nonlinear potential energy tend to zero. This is can be clearly shown in this picture. This picture is show the frequency of the first phonon model, phonon peak, as the function of the temperature. So in the low temperature, the anharmonic terms not change his frequency. So in the low temperature, the nonlinear potential energy is tended to zero, but the lifetime of the phonons dramatically smaller than the harmonic ones. This really means there really exists anharmonic effect. So for figure out this confusion, we calculate the expansion coefficient as a function of the energy density. Or we also say the temperature. So in the low temperature, for the FPU alpha beta model with the alpha equal to this two value, the expansion coefficient is equal to alpha. That is very agreement with the Kittel's estimations. So this picture shows in the low temperature, the system for the system with the chance with the asymmetry potential is have a asymmetry because it shows expansion coefficient. So from this result, we can say the anharmonicity from two sources in the FPU alpha beta model. One is the asymmetry. This dominates the phonon decay in the low temperature region. And another is nonlinearity. It dominates the phonon decay in the high temperature region. Here we want to define the nonlinearity. That means the force between the neighboring particles as the function of the relative displacement is not linear. In the middle region of the temperature, there is a mixing effect of both asymmetry and the nonlinearity on phonons. So in the we use the peak analysis. That is just show the phonons with the lowest frequency. Here we use another calculator method get the phonon lifetime. In this method is we directly calculate the energy fluctuations of the phonons. This is a decay in the not in the standard exponential way, but the compressed exponential way. That means the exponent sigma is greater than 1. So here is the lifetime overview of the phonons covering four Brillouin zones. Y-axis is the time, lifetime, rescaled by his period. And the x-axis is the reduced wave number. So this red triangle indicate the PFU model. That means the higher temperature limit. This is show very long the lifetime, and show the very perfect the power law. But this blue symbol and the red symbol show the FPU alpha beta model. That means for a long wavelength phonons, the lifetime of a phonon dramatically reduced. We also calculated the LGA model. Okay, so okay. I make a conclusion. So, if time not permit, so the asymmetry dramatically reduce the phonon lifetimes and lead to violate the hypothesis lifetime greater than this hypothesis. Small asymmetry alone lead to the behavior gamma equal to one. Large asymmetry facilitate the hydrodynamic behavior, and the stronger symmetry nonlinearity lead to hydrodynamic behavior. That means the gamma equal between the 1.5 and 2, and the lifetime greater much than the periodic. So thanks.